Incidents like this past weekend's human smuggling attempt outside that Southside Walmart really come as no surprise to anybody who's been smuggled across the U.S. border.
This morning, reporter Oscar Margain is in Laredo with the story of a Cuban immigrant who has seen it all after spending 2 years traveling to reach the southern border.
One thing that brings people of all walks of life together is food. That's especially true at the Emmanuel Baptist Church in Laredo, where 3 Cubans, a Mexican and a pastor, have invited us to the table, each one with a story to tell about how they made it to the U.S.
Me siento increíblemente bien. Me siento en paz.
34-year-old Ray, who asked to conceal his full name to not jeopardize his immigration case, says he's finally in peace after 2 years traveling Latin America to reach Laredo.
Trinidad y Tobago, Guyana, Brazil, Colombia.
All in all, he crossed 12 countries, he said, where he witnessed some of the most horrifying moments in his life.
Violadas, estafadas, muertas.
He says he saw people being raped, scammed, physically abused, and even killed along the way. Everyone paying a high price to reach the U.S. Ray recalls how he was crammed in beds of trucks with other immigrants for hours as he was smuggled through Central America. $10,000 is what Ray had to pay to reach the border. And to his misfortune, on the very day he finally made it to Laredo Port of Entry in January, President Obama officially ended the wet foot, dry foot policy that gave immediate refuge to Cubans. Stuck in Mexico, he became a target to cartels.
Estuve secuestrado 4 días.
Kidnapped for 4 days. That's all Ray is willing to say about that ordeal. After he escaped and waiting 4 months, he was granted a court hearing in the U.S. for political asylum. All he wanted was to be heard, he says, even if that meant spending time at a detention center. He wanted to do it the right way. Simply to live free.
Ray is waiting on news of his next parole hearing. He says it's one step closer to achieving his dream of building a business and a family in America. In Laredo, on the Texas-Mexico border, I'm Oscar Margain reporting.